Hi everyone, my name is Berta and welcome back to my channel. Today we are making another sim in my Zodiac Signs as Sims series. And today we're making Aries as a sim. You are an Aries if you were born between the 21st of March and the 20th of April. So let's talk about this Zodiac sign for a second. The element of this zodiac sign is fire and their color is red. As you will be able to tell, I try to incorporate red in all her outfits. Aries are fiery and dynamic people who like to be in the center of attention. They are spontaneous, uninhibited and open and can be quite focused on themselves, and they can be stubborn. They are natural discoverers, and even though Aries are aware of their big ego, they will still seek attention from other people aware of what they can offer to them. It is important to learn introspection, because if they don't, they might break down when their big ego gets undermined. To develop, Aries need to physically explore boundaries. That's also why they prefer action over contemplation. That is also why I made the sim quite sporty. I was thinking about how to represent this trait of Aries as something you can see in people, so I decided, you know, action, sport, let's make this a sporty person. So yeah, they don't like ruminating about problems, but face them head on. And when they can't for some reason do this, they might suffer and it can be helpful to take a step back. Aries are born to lead, and when they lack the skills to do this, they get frustrated or even self-pity. At their worst, Aries can be insensitive, egoistic people, but at their best they can be idealistic pioneers. If you want to know more about zodiac signs, astrology and stuff, I got all this information from a book called The Secret Language of Birthdays, written by Gary Goldschneider and Joost Elfers. I will leave a link to the book in the description, so in case you are into astrology, you can check out this book. I do recommend it. So let me know, are you an Aries? Or do you know someone who is an Aries? And do you recognize yourself or the other person in the description I just gave to you? Let me know, I'm very curious. So, how are you guys doing? I am doing all right. Ever since I stopped studying, I'm feeling less stressed and I'm sleeping better, so that's really great. And I'm working on videos a lot, which I really enjoy doing, so I'm good. How about you? I have got hay fever right now though, because I am allergic to a certain type of tree. I don't know what the English word is, but a tree and also a type of grass, but this tree blooms like very early in the year, and so I am now sneezing a lot. Also, since I've got more time right now because of the quarantine, I am watching series with my boyfriend. I usually don't really watch a lot of series. I do watch series, but like one episode a week or something, or I binge, there's no in between. But we have finished watching The Crown, which I really enjoyed, and we have also finished in a few days the new series Freud. It has as I said, it's new, so it has one season. I couldn't find the word there, but yeah, one season, and I really enjoyed it. It's a historical mystery crime series, and I had seen The Alienist before, which I really, really enjoyed, and I definitely do recommend both The Alienist and Freud to you if you like historical mystery and crime series. But yeah, Freud was really interesting. As you know, I am into psychology because I studied it until last week. So it was really interesting to see a series with Freud as the main character, and they kind of reimagined his life, and it was very interesting. Like, it all it was a lot about hypnosis and you know, the power of suggestion and multiple personalities and what is reality and what is not. So when we finished it, my boyfriend and I, we really were both thinking like, what did we just watch? But like in a good way. It was really interesting. And also my boyfriend studies film and he said it was really well done, like cinematically and stuff. I don't know if that's the right word, but he was impressed by it. So go watch it if you like those kind of series. I also, if you want more recommendations, really like The Shannara Chronicles, Orange is the New Black, and You. Am I missing something? Oh yeah, Atypical. I haven't finished watching Atypical yet, but I really, really enjoy that series. So go watch it. Do you have any recommendations for me? Because I am often very overwhelmed with the number of series that I can choose from. So if you can recommend me things based on the series I just mentioned, that would be really great. About The Sim, I did struggle sometimes to find some, you know, clothing items that really suit her figure, because she is really muscular and stuff. Some things looked better than others. And for example, I was looking for a dress for her formal wear, but I ended up giving her this awesome suit because it just it suited her way better. So that's what I went with. And I also gave her a lot of sporty outfits. I think I gave her 3 athletic outfits, and then her warm weather outfit is also quite sporty. So very sporty girl. I asked my boyfriend, I showed him like this sim without any outfits on, and asked him like, okay, she's obviously very sporty, what kind of sports would you think she does? So he said that she would be into martial arts, hockey, and running. So like she would, you know, do martial arts every week and hockey every week, but then in the weekends or in the mornings she would go running by herself. So that's what I basically gave her athletic outfits for. Her first athletic outfit is like based on what people that do boxing wear. And I gave her a running outfit with longer sleeves. And I gave her, I don't know, a hockey outfit. I don't know what hockey outfits really look like. Well, I do, but replicating it in The Sims is different. So I did my best. I think I gave her like a sporty skirt that people who tennis and play hockey wear, if I'm correct. I know nothing about sports, okay? I am not a sporty person. I like to dance and I like to go skating, but that's it. Like I really don't like any team sports. Not because I don't like the idea of a team sport, it's just I am so bad at them, especially ones that involve a ball. Like basketball, I'm terrible. Football, terrible. I do like volleyball a bit more, but again, terrible. I'm just so terrible at sports. And running, don't even get me started. I don't like sports except for dancing and skating. I do think there is a valid reason though as to why I am so bad at sports that involve like team play and balls. Because when I was 14, I think I had to do an IQ test, and that also involves measuring visual reaction time, and everything came out normal and like very good actually, except for visual reaction time. Apparently my brain processes visual stimuli slower than normal, like slower than the average person. So what I think might explain me being terrible at ball sports is the fact that I don't see the ball coming in time and therefore can't catch it, can't hit it, can't, you know, I think you get what I mean. I think that's why I'm so bad at these kind of sports. Then there's also the aspect of, you know, your teammates and having an overview of where everyone is and what actions you can do. And then I have ADHD, which makes it impossible for me to have this kind of overview. And in combination with these slow visual reaction times, I'm just not good at these things, okay? So yeah, I prefer dancing and skating. It just doesn't involve visual reaction times as much as those other sports do. Ah yeah, and I also like swimming. Do you like sports? And what sports do you like? You know, right now in the quarantine, being active is difficult, in my opinion. I don't really know how to motivate myself to do things at home. Like, I have just dance, so I would be able to do that, but for some reason I can't motivate myself to do that. So, if you have any tips on how to motivate yourself to do, you know, sports in the house by yourself, please let me know. Do you have any routines or something that help you? I would like to know. Also, you may have noticed that I gave this sim a lot of, you know, updos, like ponytails and braids and buns and stuff. That's because, I don't know how about you, but I, when I do sport, dancing or whatever, I hate it when there's hair in my face. I mean, it does seem like other people don't mind it as much, but I don't like it. And so I imagined that this girl was very practical and would also get her hair out of her face while doing sports. Also, the traits and aspirations I gave her. Her aspiration is the leader of the pack, you know, to represent the fact that Aries are very good leaders. Then I gave her the active trait, as I said, to represent the preference of action over contemplation of Aries. I also gave her the self-absorbed trait to represent the egoistical side, or, you know, self-centered side of the Aries that they can sometimes have. And I gave her the outgoing sign. I don't really remember why, but there was a reason, okay. I also noticed that I haven't given her a name yet. I mean, her name right now is Aries. So I need to come up with a name. But yeah, I'll change that before uploading the sim to the gallery. We're nearing the end of the video, so I'm gonna wrap this up right here and show you the screenshots. This sim will be on the gallery, and I probably will make a CC list. If I do, you will be able to find it in the description of the video, so you can download the sim and have all the outfits and looks and stuff in your game as well. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, but you do like to see more videos like this, please consider hitting that subscribe button and the notification bell to be notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye!